To help your Gator utility vehicle last a long time, it's important to perform regular scheduled maintenance. Today, we will show you how to change the oil filter and engine oil. Before starting any maintenance, be sure to recognize safety information, understand safety signals, and be familiar with your operator's manual. You will need clean shop towels, a new oil filter, new engine oil, a drain pan, a funnel, and an oil filter wrench. Please refer to your operator's manual for the oil weight and amount. Run the engine to warm the oil. Park the machine safely on a level surface and allow the engine to cool. Be sure to fully lower any attachments on the ground and fully engage the park brake. Raise and secure the cargo box. Remove the key. Disconnect the battery. Now we will drain the oil. Remove the oil fill cap from the filler opening. Position a drain pan under the engine pan drain hole and the oil filter drain hole in the frame. Remove the engine pan drain hole plug and drain the oil into the oil drain pan. Allow the oil to drain completely. Next, we will remove the oil filter. On XUV865 machines, the best access is from the passenger side of the vehicle between the tire and the wheel well. Wipe around the oil filter to remove any debris. If needed, use an oil filter wrench, twisting the oil filter counterclockwise to loosen it. Drain any residual oil from the filter into the drain pan prior to disposal. Write the date and machine engine hours on the filter. Allow to dry. Apply a layer of clean engine oil on the gasket of the new filter. To install the new filter, turn clockwise until the gasket contacts the filter base. Once the filter is in place, give an additional 1/2 turn to ensure a good seal. Be careful not to over-tighten the filter. Install the drain plug and tighten to specification outlined in your operator's manual. Use a funnel to add oil. Fill the oil to the recommended level as outlined in the specification section of your operator's manual. It is important to not overfill or underfill your engine. Next, we will check the oil level. Clean around the dipstick to remove any debris before removing it. Be sure that the oil level is between the add and full marks. Reconnect the battery. Start and run the engine at idle to check for any leaks. If needed, stop the engine and fix any leaks before proceeding. Check the oil level again and add oil if necessary. Now you can lower the cargo box and you are all set. Remember to follow the local proper instructions for oil recycling and oil filter disposal. To purchase parts, visit your local John Deere dealer or visit jdparts.deere.com. Thank you for choosing John Deere.